For our next hot copy, after the success of his film Easter Sunday, which showcases the light side of Filipino culture in the U.S., Jokoy is coming back to Manila for another show. And he is here with us. Welcome to Hot Copy, Jokoy.
How are you?
I was going to say, finally. Well, you know,
I'm here.
I know, but I wanted to tell you that the first time you were in Manila, you had a show. I actually watched you live. I just wasn't able to go backstage. But I was there. I watched you. My husband and I watched you. So my first question is, what's the difference of this show? This is your Funny is Funny tour compared to your first show.
My first one was my first time back, I think. So, you know, a lot has happened since then. You know, along with the movie and by the way, I'm getting ready to drop my fourth Netflix special.
Wow.
That comes out September 13th. So you guys get to see that before it airs. Oh, there's Inna's Elements. I shot that in the Philippines. That was amazing.
Yeah, I saw that.
That's incredible.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, so, you know, that was my third special for Netflix. I just want you to know, I didn't even get paid for that. I did that for free. I just wanted to go to the Philippines and showcase the Philippines. That was my whole sell to Netflix.
Yeah,
I was let's go to the Philippines and show some love.
Yeah, you are a true advocate of bringing the Philippines to the world, I have to say, right? I mean, not just love for country, but even the jokes. And not everybody can relate to Filipino jokes or Phil-Am jokes, and yet here you are taking it out there.
Well, I mean, I love you, Karen, for saying that, but I'm going to disagree with you because it's not... You don't have to be Filipino to get a mom's joke. It's a mom. My mom is a mom. And my son is a son. And she just happens to be Filipino. And that's the beauty of comedy is we can laugh and we can cry. And at the end, you'll find out that we're all relatable. And that's how I got Steven Spielberg involved is through the jokes that I tell on at Netflix. So... You know, that's what we got to do. We got to do more stuff and tell more, not relatable, but just talk more about yourself and be vulnerable and not be scared to shine light on things that you think is probably negative. But when you do that, you realize that everyone else does it too, you know?
Yeah. And not only that, I was going to say in the United States, with you shining a light on Filipino culture through Netflix, through your jokes, would you say, Jokoy, that it's strengthening the Filipino minority bloc power in the U.S.?
I mean, yeah. You know, what I love the most is, you know, the movie is the one that I'm really, like, so excited about because, you know, you're looking at this movie was the first movie ever produced by a major studio. Ever. So like we're talking all Asians across the board. So this was the first one and it just happened to be that it's based on a Filipino family.
Yeah.
Thank you, God. Yeah. And you know, and I got DreamWorks, I got Steven Spielberg behind it. So that was like the most beautiful thing to happen in my career because we're showing the world that you can tell your story.
Yeah.
And we don't have to be typecast anymore.
Yes.
And it's like, be yourself. And like, if I want to talk about my mom, I'm going to talk about my mom. And like, I'm proud of that because if I don't do it, then who's going to do it?
Yes.
Who's and going to let my mom be seen in Hollywood? My mom's been living in America for 53 years and she's never seen any Filipino on American TV. So I'm just happy we got to do this on the world stage. So
and not only that, I was gonna say that we've seen Hollywood films that had an all Chinese cast, for example. Korean films are famous all over the world and they're all Korean. So it is such an achievement to actually just have a film in Hollywood that's all Filipino and received in this way. But where do you get Jokoy
from? Karen, I want to interrupt.
Go ahead.
Can I interrupt you again? But not only that, it was produced by DreamWorks.
Yes.
you got to put that out there.
Yeah.
It was the first movie. Like all the movies you just named, I loved. God bless them. But how amazing that this one was the first one to be produced by a major studio like Universal Pictures and DreamWorks. It's incredible. And just to have Steven
Spielberg. So, you know, my question to you, how did you sell it? I mean, of course, the fact they produced it means that they saw it would be good. But was it easy in the beginning for you to sell the idea?
Okay, so I've been in Hollywood 33 years, and it was the hardest sell of my life.
Yeah.
And, you know, my first Netflix special, it's called Live from Seattle.
Yeah.
They said no to me 8 times, so I paid for it myself out of my own pocket. I made that myself and then sold it to Netflix. And then after that, that's when I got Coming in Hot, and that's the one Steven Spielberg watched. Mm. And he brought me into Amblin, and I pitched Easter Sunday, and they bought it in the room. And it literally was, you know, when I tell you this, it sounds like an overnight success story, but it was 33 years in the making. And it was just a lot of determination that I was going to stick to my story, no matter how many times he said, not everyone's going to get it. You know, they kept saying that I was too specific. Oh, you keep talking about your mom. They're not going to get it. I didn't care. I was going to keep telling it because I knew people would get it. And it eventually happened.
Yeah. And what are you seeing in the long run, Jokoy? I'm sure this won't be your last film. I mean, are you running out of ideas, so to speak, on how to tell stories about the Filipino culture? I mean, how to bring us out into the world?
I think what it is just tell your story, right? Like I keep saying this, but my mom's lived here for 53 years. And she's never seen a Filipino on TV until now. And what I mean by that is like representation.
Yeah.
I don't mean just Filipino. I don't want to exclude all the Filipino actors.
You don't mean a Filipino actor. That's not what you mean.
That's representing a Filipino, being Filipino. And since she's been here for 53 years, I got 53 years worth of stories I need to tell.
Yeah, okay.
So I'm gonna keep going.
All right, now Jokoy, when you come back to the Philippines, your funny is funny. What can we expect from that, Jokoy?
This is more of me and personal and you know, also telling my story on, you know, how hard it was, the struggle in this business. But you know, you get to see it before we drop that hour, you know, and that's one thing I'm really proud about, that this is my fourth special and I get to go to the Philippines and do it live before anyone else gets to see it on Netflix.
Yeah. You know, I wanted to ask you a personal question. Are you always happy?
I am.
Really?
I really, really am. And it's kind of hard to date me.
So you brought up dating. I wasn't going to bring it up. So is it right to say you're single now?
On another level.
But are you single now?
Oh, yeah, yeah. I'm single. I've been single for a minute now,
For a minute. So are you, do you want to date again? Are you going to date? Are you open to dating?
I'm open to dating, but right now it's going to be hard to date me because I'm really hyper-focused because this is the part of the career that I've been waiting for a long time. And I have a huge responsibility. A lot of people in this business are in it for, you know, personal or whatever it is. But I got the weight of a lot of people on my back and I want to make sure I carry it high and do everyone proud.
Yeah, because it's very difficult to make it to Hollywood, no matter where you're from, all over the world. It's not easy. And yet here you are. Your center stage representing the Filipino. To some degree, you said you felt pressure. But did you also fear failure?
No.
No.
I mean, if you feel like that's going to happen, then you. I say this to anyone that's trying to make it in this business.
Yeah.
If you're scared of failure, then you might not want to do show business.
Yeah.
Because you fail every day. And they will tell you to your face, like, you know, when you go to an audition and when you pitch an idea, or if you have, you know, a production that you want to create, or if you want to direct a certain, you know, movie or whatever it is, and they say no, 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 every single time, you feel like a failure. And the minute you feel like that, you might as well quit, because I never felt that way. I was like, all right, fine. You said no. I have to keep moving until I get that yes.
Wow, that's amazing. Anything you want to say, Jokoy? Anything you want to add before we go? And I do hope to see you here when you're in Manila. Finally.
I'm coming to see you, all right? Okay. Let's you and me and your husband, we'll get something to eat and we'll talk. We'll keep
that
talking.
Would be lovely. That would be lovely.
I love what you do, and I just, man, everything about, you know, I used to live in the Philippines. You do know that, right?
Yeah.
And I'm in love with how Filipinos embrace entertainment on all aspects, on every color of the spectrum, from singing to reporting to acting
to dancing.
And, you know, it's in our blood, and I love it and I appreciate it.
Yeah. All right. So, Jokoy, anything you wanted to add for all your fans? I mean, I'm sure this will be sold out. I know it's on August 31. It's at the SM Mall of Asia Arena, which is huge. Ooh, so anything fire. You want to say?
Let's just keep building and let's just keep getting stronger. And whenever someone is successful, and not just me, anyone within our community and our culture, raise them up high and lift them up high and keep the door open. We have a tendency to have that crab mentality and pull people down. And what eventually happens is the door closes again.
Yeah.
And we don't need the door to close. Keep this door wide open. The door's open.
Beautiful. Thank you so much. Jokoy, thank you so much. Unfortunately, we don't have enough time, but I do hope to speak with you at a longer length at one point in time. So good luck, and I'll see you in Manila. Yes.
I love you. I'll see you right when I get there.
All right. You take care.